brothers and sisters, to increase your iman. Read the miracle, recite the Qur'an. Recite it every day and do read it loud. The verses of Qur'an are all Muslims' pride. This miracle was revealed over a long time span, sent from Allah to an angel, then to a man. That man was Muhammad, the best of creation.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salamu ala nabiyihi wa mustafa sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa man wala. Dear brothers and sisters, we're very pleased to join you once again with a live episode of Correct Your Recitation. Today, inshallah, we'll begin by reciting from verse number 15 of Surat An-Naze'aat. Surat An-Naze'aat is chapter number 79. And as we discussed before, it's a Makki chapter. So all the verses will be pertaining to Aqeedah, belief, life after death, etc. As usual, inshallah, we'll begin by listening to a beautiful recitation by our dear reciter, Sheikh Ismail. Then afterward, inshallah, in the next segment, we'll be more than happy to take your live phone calls. Phone number 002, area code 02-3855-248-249. Brothers and sisters, please join us and listen carefully to the recitation of Surah An-Naze'aat from verse number 15 all the way to the end of the surah. Sheikh Ismail, tafaddal.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم هل أتاك حديث موسى إذ ناداه ربه بالوادي المقدس طوى اذهب إلى فرعون إنه طغى فقل هل لك إلى أن تزكى وأهديك إلى ربك فتخشى فأراه الآية الكبرى فكذب وعصى ثم أدبر يسعى فحشر فنادى فقال أنا ربكم الأعلى فأخذه الله نكال الآخرة والأولى إن في ذلك لعبرة لمن يخشى أأنتم أشد خلقا أم السماء بناها رفع سمكها فسواها وأغطش ليلها وأخرج ضحاها والأرض بعد ذلك دحاها أخرج منها ماءها ومرعاها والجبال أرساها متاعا لكم ولأنعامكم فإذا جاءت الطامة الكبرى يوم يتذكر الإنسان ما سعى وبرزت الجحيم لمن يرى فأما من طغى وآثر الحياة الدنيا فإن الجحيم هي المأوى وأما من خاف مقام ربه ونهى النفس عن الهوى فإن الجنة هي المأوى يسألونك عن الساعة أيان مرساها فيما أنت من ذكراها إلى ربك منتهاها إنما أنت منذر من يخشاها كأنهم يوم يرونها لم يلبثوا إلا عشية أو ضحاها.
جزاك الله خيرا. May Allah bless you and your family. Barak. Brothers and sisters, from verse number 15 through verse number 26, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is narrating to us and shedding some light on a part of the story of Prophet Moses, peace be upon him, with the Pharaoh. This very important story, which was discussed in various chapters of the Qur'an, various other verses such as Surah Taha and Surah Al-Qasas, etc. This part, in brief, would give us some very valuable information about what kind of dialogue that went on between Musa alayhi salam and the tyrant king, the Pharaoh who claimed to be the Lord, and what was the outcome of his preaching to the Pharaoh, and the outcome to the disobedience and the rebelliousness of the Pharaoh. Before that, it is very important to take you in a quick tour with the word bank, some of the vocabulary which would like to know their meanings and their derivatives, in order to be aware of the meaning of those verses afterward whenever we meet them in other parts of the Qur'an. The word tazakka, which was mentioned in verse number 18. Tazakka, which means to purify yourself. We find in Surah Al-Shams, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swore 11 times, Al-Shams al-Duhaha, wal-Qamari idha talaha, etc. All the way until he concluded the oath by saying, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ زَكَّاهَا وَقَدْ خَابَ مَنْ دَسَّاهَا. So only those who purify themselves by believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by avoiding sins, will be the truly successful ones. Then, the next one will be the word yas'a, and that's a word in verse number 22. The word yas'a, like we have in al-hajj wal-umrah, there is one of the pillars of both hajj and umrah, which is as-sa'd, which is to walk briskly or to haste while walking, so walking in haste. And this is what the Pharaoh did when Musa preached him. So he turned around and he was walking in haste, and he was working hard in his resentment to oppose Musa alayhi salam. The word فَحَشَرَ فَنَادَ, what the Pharaoh did, he gathered and he assembled. He assembled his people. So حَشَرَ, and from that is one of the days of the day of resurrection, which is يَوْمُ الْحَشْرِ, or the gathering or assembly. And there is a chapter in the Quran basically which is known as Surah Al-Hashr. The word نَكَال, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punished the Pharaoh, nakal means the punishment. The word ibrah means an admonition or a lesson. Inna fi dhalika la'ibratan liman yakhsha. And who would learn the lesson and who would receive the admonition? Those who truly fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The word samkaha, samka, or samaka Allahu samaa, means he raised it high. Samkaha, he raised its height. Allah raised the heavens, the sky, without pillars, without shackles that holds the sky in the space. Al-tasha is relating to the night. He covers it with darkness. Duhaha, from duha, and from that is the duha prayer, which is a forenoon prayer, past sunrise. Dahaha, that is relating to the earth, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spread the earth and he made it subservient to us in order to walk on it and earn our provision. Mar'a means pasture, and it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who produced the pasture out of the earth after he spread it. Arsaha is a word that's related to the mountains. The pronoun of ha are referring to the mountains, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala kept the mountains firmly fixed on earth. All of that was made as a mata'. A mata' is a provision or a benefit, obviously, for us. Now, in brief, we will go back to the story of Musa alayhi salam, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called him in the sacred valley of Tua. And what did he tell him? He said, اذهب إلى فرعون إنه طغى. He appointed him with the prophethood. And the prophethood is not just an honor, it's a responsibility. Now you need to go and deliver the message to whom? To the Pharaoh? To the most tyrant man on earth? To the one who claimed that he is God? He did not just claim that he is the only king or. No, he claimed that he is God. Basically, he said once, مَا عَلِمْتُ لَكُمْ مِنْ إِلَهٍ غَيْرِي. I do not know for you any other God other than myself. Then when Musa alayhi salam came and he preached him and he delivered the message to him, he cried out loud and said, أَنَا رَبُّكُمُ الْأَعْلَى. I am your Lord, the Most High, as we will see right now. We find in Surah Taha very interesting mean of approach that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala instructed Musa alayhi salam and his brother Harun as how to give da'wah. And we got to learn from that. He said, اذهبا إلى فرعون إنه طغى. go both of you to the Pharaoh, because he transgressed all bounds. So the Qur'an admitted that this guy was a very big tyrant and transgressor. Yet, how to give him da'wah? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَقُولَ لَهُ قَوْلًا لَيِّنًا لَعَلَّهُ يَتَذَكَّرُ أَوْ يَخْشَى. That's verse number 44 of Surah Taha, by the way, chapter number 20. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala instructed Musa and his brother Harun to preach the Pharaoh with kindness, with gentleness. فَقُولَ لَهُ قَوْلًا لَيِّنًا. Mild, soft, gentle statement. Perhaps he will be reminded, or he might fear me. قَالَ رَبَّنَا إِنَّنَا نَخَافُ أَن يَفْرُطَ عَلَيْنَا أَوْ أَن يَطْغَى. Both Musa and Harun were afraid that he's going to kill them, he's going to transgress against them. And he's been doing that for decades. قَالَ لَا تَخَافَا إِنَّنِي مَعَكُمَا أَسْمَعُ وَأَرَى. So Allah the Almighty assured them, I'm fully aware of what's going on. I know who is the Pharaoh. And I know that I'm sending you and I'm supervising you because I am with you, I hear and I see. And this is what every believer should put their trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and should understand that Allah is the hafiz, Allah is the greatest protector. And if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala were to protect anyone, then no one can ever harm him. So Musa alayhi salam in verse number 18 eventually did. And he went to the Pharaoh and said, هَلْ لَكَ إِلَىٰ أَن تَزَكَّى وَأَهْدِيَكَ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ فَتَخْشَى. He said, would you purify yourself from what? From sins, from disbelief, from claiming that you are the Lord. And I shall guide you to your Lord, so you should fear him. Basically, you only respect, love, or fear someone whom you know. Who is he? You're fully aware of his traits and characteristics. There comes for us the importance and the significance of learning and being aware of the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why in Surah Fatir, we find a magnificent verse that acknowledges the fact that only the knowledgeable ones who fear Allah most. إِنَّمَا يَخْشَى اللَّهَ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ الْعُلَمَاءِ. That's verse number 28 of Surah Fatir. Surah Fatir is chapter number 35. So what happened? Eventually the Pharaoh belied and denied his message. So he asked him for a sign. فَأَرَاهُ الْآيَةَ الْكُبَرَى. So Moses عليه السلام showed the Pharaoh the mighty sign. That sign was the miracles that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even though the word ayah is singular, but it's referring to the major two signs or miracles that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala supported Musa with, which is, number one, his can or stick, when he threw it and it turned into a humongous snake, and the second, his hand was illuminating like nur or light when he took it out of his pocket. So what was the result of that? After seeing the signs and the miracles, فَكَذَّبَ وَعَصَى, the Pharaoh still, he belied, and he was very arrogant, and he disobeyed. ثُمَّ أَدَبَرَ يَسْعَى. Then he turned back, and he was walking hastily. So he did not pay any attention to what Musa said. Rather, he did totally the opposite. He gathered the people, and he assembled them. فَحَشَرَ فَنَادَى. In verse number 23, فَحَشَرَ فَنَادَى. He assembled his people, then he cried out loud. What did he say? فَقَالَ أنا ربكم الأعلى. He said, I am your Lord, the Most High. Do not believe this guy. He's a liar, him and his brother. They're coming in order to overtake the power and take Egypt, etc. These false claims. So he belied them, and furthermore, he said, فقال أنا ربكم الأعلى. The Mufassirin or the interpreter said, the first statement which he said, which was mentioned in Surah Al-Qasas, when he said, ما علمت لكم من إله غيري. And then the later statement, which he declared that he is the greatest Lord by saying, أَنَا رَبُّكُمُ الْأَعْلَى. Between them there was 40 years. As a result of his resentment to the truth, and his belying the message of Prophet Musa alayhi salam, and challenging Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by every possible means that he had, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala seized them with severe punishment. فَأَخَذَهُ اللَّهُ نَكَالَ الْآخِرَةِ وَالْأُولَى. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees them with the punishment for the last and the first. What is the last and what is the first? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees them with the punishment for his last and his first transgression. You remember what I said in Surah Al-Qasas when he said, مَا عَلِمْتُ لَكُمْ مِنْ إِلَهٍ غَيْرِ. Then 4 years later when he declared that, أَنَا رَبُّكُمُ الْأَعْلَى. So the punishment that he received in his life was a humiliating punishment. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala drowned the Pharaoh and his entire army. But he said to the Pharaoh, فَالْيَوْمَ نُنَجِّيكَ بِبَدَنِكَ لِتَكُونَ لِمَنْ خَلْفَكَ آيَةً. So Allah rescued the body of the Pharaoh in order to be a sign, a lesson, an admonition for every tyrant, for every disbeliever, for everyone who may transgress after him. Look, this is somebody who claimed that he is the Lord. Look at him. Look at his rotten dead body. And I said before that I visited the museum in Cairo, Egypt, downtown Cairo, Egypt, and I've seen his mummy. It's an awful scene. This is a rotten body of somebody whom one day claimed that he is God. Look how insignificant is this human being to challenge Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and claim that he is the Lord. And how insane a person who may think for a moment that he can benefit or harm even himself. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who creates. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who provides and sustains. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who protects from any harm. It is only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who gives benefit and provision. إِنَّ فِي ذَٰلِكَ لَعِبْرَةً لِمَنْ يَخْشَى. In this severe punishment, in this mummy which we see of the Pharaoh, or Ramses II, or whatever, there is a lesson, there is a ibrah, there is an admonition. For whom? We have a lot of tourists who would come and take pictures, and even some Muslims would enjoy the scene, enjoy wandering in the temples, and do not really draw the lessons and the admonitions which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala meant behind preserving the body or the mummy of the Pharaoh, which is, learn from him. Fear Allah, because sooner or later, you're going to join him. So either you purify yourself and you'll be saved, or you'll destroy yourself and you'll end up in the fire of hell. Everyone has a lifespan that no one would exceed his lifespan, not even by a moment. Nor would anyone die missing a single moment of his life. If this is the case, then we should really recognize the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, acknowledge the fact that there will be a day of recompense and we have to work hard to prepare ourselves for it. إِنَّ فِي ذَٰلِكَ لَعِبْرَةً لِمَنْ يَخْشَى. I want you to go back to the verse of Surah Fatir in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّمَا يَخْشَى اللَّهَ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ الْعُلَمَاءِ. That's why you find those who are more learned in religion sciences, that they fear Allah most, they pray most. We find the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was the most devoutly worshipping person, even though he was a chosen servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even though once when he stood up in prayer until his feet swelled, Aisha radiyallahu ta'ala anha wa ardaha asked him, Ya Rasulullah, why do you burden yourself so much? وَقَدْ غَفَرَ اللَّهُ لَكَ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِكَ وَمَا تَأَخَّرَ. Heaven is guaranteed for you. Why do you burden yourself so much with ibadah to the point that you hurt yourself and feet will get swelled? So النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said, Ya Aisha, أَفَلَا أَكُونُ عَبَدًا شَكُورًا. Shall I not be a grateful servant to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Only those who know about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, only those who have the religious knowledge, they do indeed fear Allah most. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking a rhetorical question. أَأَنْتُمْ أَشَدُّ خَلْقًا أَمِ السَّمَاءُ بَنَاهَا. Is your creation greater or the creation of the heavens and the earth? Particularly the heavens. Why the heavens? In many chapters of the Qur'an, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala challenges His creatures, particularly human beings, with the creation of the heavens. فَارْجِعِ الْبَصَرَ هَلْ تَرَى مِنْ فُطُورٍ in Surah Tabarak al-Mulk. Look back to the sky. Look at the magnificent creation of the heavens. Do you see any drawbacks, any fissures, any faults? Nothing. ثُمَّ ارْجِعِ الْبَصَرَ كَرَّتَيْنِ يَنْقَلِبْ إِلَيْكَ الْبَصَرُ خَاسِئًا وَهُوَ حَسِيرٌ. Then look again, and look again. There is no faults in it, because it had been created by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We need to look at the sky. We need to look at the heavens and wonder, has it been lifted without shackles, without hooks, without poles, without pillars, and with its vast distance that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala lifted and rose the sky, the heavens, without any support, only by His leave. Is the creation of the heavens greater or the creation of a human being from mud or from clay? أَأَنْتُمْ أَشَدُّ خَلْقًا أَمِ السَّمَاءُ بَنَاهَا. Are you more difficult to create or the heavens that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala built? How did He build it? رَفَعَ سَمْكَهَا فَسَوَّاهَا. Verse number 28. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who raised it high and perfected it. وَأَغْطَشَ لَيْلَهَا وَأَخْرَجَ ضُحَاهَا. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to talk about everything that's under the heaven, the day and the night. And he began by the night by saying, it is he who made its night dark. أغطش ليلها. He covered its night and brought it forth with darkness. وأخرج ضحاها. And he brought forth the forenoon or the morning with the light. والأرض بعد ذلك دحاها. Even though the word بعد means after that, but it does not necessarily mean the order, because in fact, Dino, the earth was created before the heaven, way before the heavens. But بعد ذلك means along with that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spread the earth and He made it subservient for us. أخرج منها ماءها ومرعاها. And He brought forth out of the earth, which He spread and made subservient for us, its water and its pasture. مَتَاعًا لَكُمْ وَلِأَنْعَامِكُمْ. But before that, in verse number 32, وَالْجِبَالَ أَرْسَاهَا. And He made the earth stable by fixing the mountains in it. Why did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala do all of that? As a provision and as a benefit for you and for your cattle. مَتَاعًا لَكُمْ وَلِأَنْعَامِكُمْ. Doesn't the one who created all of that and created us and made everything subservient to us deserve to be worshipped alone, deserve to be thanked alone, deserve to spend your entire life in devout worshipping to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? في سورة الذاريات, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala concludes in brief the purpose of our creation by saying, وَمَا خَلَقَتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ مَا أُرِيدُ مِنْهُمْ مِنْ رِزْقٍ وَمَا أُرِيدُ أَنْ يُطْعِمُونَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الرَّزَّاقُ ذُو الْقُوَّةِ الْمَتِينَ. I have not created the jinn and ins, but only to worship me, Allah the Almighty is saying. I'm not looking for any provision from them. I don't want even them to provide for themselves, because I am the one who provides for every living creature. And في سورة تبارك الملك, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us with one of His bounties, with one of His countless bounties on us by saying, وَالَّذِي جَعَلَ لَكُمُ الْأَرْضَ ذَلُولًا فَامْشُوا فِي مَنَاكِبِهَا وَكُلُوا مِنْ رِزْقِهِ وَإِلَيْهِ النُّشُورِ. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who made the earth subservient to us. We need to look around us. We need to look above us. Look at the heavens, look at the earth, look at the plants, look at the animals, look at the cattle, look at the day and the night. Recognize some of Allah's countless bounties in order to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters, inshallah, we'll take a short break, then return back with the practice of reciting the verses which we have studied all the way to the end of Surah An-Naze'aat. Perhaps we'll begin Surah Abasa wa tawalla, and it's another surah makkiya inshaAllah azza jal. Until then, please stay tuned. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Recite it every day and do read it loud.
True life of the Muslim starts at death. If you wish to enhance your knowledge of the Islamic perspective on the hereafter, this life doesn't go on forever, but we do so little to prepare for it because most of us don't know what happens after this life ends. If you want to be amongst those who know, then join us every Saturday at 19:30 GMT for the inevitable journey. According to the Qur'an, we live in a universe that worships Allah. It is not just human beings who celebrate His praises, but animals as well. Join us every Wednesday at 20 GMT for your show, Even Animals Glorify. Earth. the human heart, greed, exploitation, hatred, all diseases of the heart. For the cure, join Huda TV every Sunday at 20 GMT for Moments for the Heart.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and welcome back. I just want to remind you, brothers and sisters, this is a live episode by the leave of Allah. Allah made this event happen and come true. We were having difficulties and trouble, financial difficulties, of course, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it so easy by His leave and then by your great support. May Allah bless you all. So, inshallah, we'll be happy to take your phone calls if any of you is tuning in today. And I would like to begin by our guest, Dino. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Why don't you recite from verse number
15? أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم هل أتاك حديث موسى إذ ناداه ربه بالوادي المقدس طوى اذهب إلى فرعون إنه طغى فقل هل لك إلى أن تزكى وأهديك إلى ربك فتخشى فأراه الآية الكبرى فكذب وعصى ثم أدبر يسعى فحشر فنادى فقال أنا ربكم الأعلى فأخذه الله نكال الآخرة والأولى.
جزاك الله خيرا. Just a simple comment. ما شاء الله. You're from where, Dino?
From Bosnia.
Bosnia. ما شاء الله. ما شاء الله. I love the Bosnian brothers and sisters. بارك الله فيك. Let's look at verse number 17. We have a couple of things. The word إذهب, there is a ba. And the ba is one of the five letters of the qalqala letters. The shalit has a sukun, right? So we have to show the qalqala. We will say, idhhab, idhhab. Okay, tending.
Idhhab.
Exactly. Idhhab. Then, ila fir'auna. Dara is extremely thin. Okay. Fir'auna. Okay? Then, when we come to say the word tagha, I understand that the ya is a thin letter, harfu muraqqa, right? But this ya would follow the previous letter in its fatness or thinness. So the ghain is harf, one of the highness or isti'la letters, and it is one of the tafkhim letters, right? Especially it has a fatha, so it is highly mufakhama. So that's why the ya would earn the same tafkhim. So do not hesitate to say tagha, okay? Some of us would tend to say طغى because he wants to soften or thin the ya. Not necessarily this is the right thing. So I would say اذهب إلى فرعون إنه طغى. Okay? جزاك الله خيرا. Then وأهديك إلى ربك. ضراء مفخمة as well. And that's verse number 19. Other than that, mashallah, la quwwata illa billah, your recitation is very, very beautiful. Very proud of you. Barakallahu feekum. Okay. Smir, from verse number 26.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. أأنتم أشد خلقا أم السماء بناها رفع سمكها فسواها وأغطش ليلها وأخرج ضحاها والأرض بعد ذلك دحاها أخرج منها ماءها ومرعاها والجبال أرساها متاعا لكم ولأنعامكم فإذا جاءت الطامة الكبرى يوم يتذكر الإنسان ما سعى وبرزت الجحيم لمن يرى.
Very nice, but we want to read this ayah once again, verse number 36. Paying attention to the ra of the word وبرزت and the ra of the word لمن يرى يرى. We've got the first ra with the kasra, so it is مرققة, very thin. And the ra of the word yara with fatha, so it is mufakhama. So notice the tarqiq in the first ra and the tafkhim in the later one. So we'll say wa burrizatil jahim liman yara. And once again, the ya would follow the same tafkhim of the letter that precedes it, which is ra. Okay? When I say it again,
wa burrizatil jahim liman yara.
Fatten the ra a little bit more. Yara.
Yara.
Yes. The ra fell between the ya and the ya, and both are thin. But it is mufakhama. So the first ya will be muraqqaqa, but the ra and the ya will be mufakhama. Liman yara.
Liman yara.
Okay. Jazakallah khair. Sister Ruqayya. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Make sure you turn the volume down, please.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والنازعات غرقا والناشطات نشطا والسابحات سبحا فالسابقات سبقا.
Every ba we meet Ruqayya قلقلة. Every ba, okay? So say والسابحات سبحا سبحا and فالسابقات سبقا
والسابحات سبحا فالسابقات سبقا.
Great.
فالمدبرات أمرا يوم ترجف الراجفة.
ترجف رقية يوم ترجف.
يوم ترجف الراجفة تتبعها الراجفة قلوب يومئذ واجفة أبصارها خاشعة يقولون أئنا لمردودون في الحافرة.
Okay, جزاكم الله خيرا رقية. Wait a minute. We notice that from verse number 6, every verse ended with the تاء مربوطة. And once we stop, it becomes a هاء. So many of us do not get to pronounce it. So we turn it into an alif. We say, تَرْجُفُ الرَّاجِفَ رَادِفَ وَاجِفَ. We got to pronounce the ha properly. So we'll say, يَوْمَ تَرْجُفُ الرَّاجِفَ تَتْبَعُهَا الرَّادِفَ قُلُوبٌ يَوْمَئِذٍ وَاجِفَ أَبَصَارُهَا خَاشِعَةٌ. Okay, جزاكم الله خيرا. أم عبد الرحمن from Egypt. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
عليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Go ahead, sister.
أَإِذَا كُنَّا عِظَامًا نَخِرَةً قَالُوا تِلْكَ إِذًا كَرَّةٌ خَاسِرَةٌ فَإِنَّمَا هِيَ زَجْرَةٌ وَاحِدَةٌ فَإِذَا هُمْ بِالسَّاهِرَةِ هَلْ أَتَاكَ حَدِيثُ مُوسَى إِذْ نَادَاهُ رَبُّهُ بِالْوَادِ الْمُقَدَّسِ طُوًى اذهب إلى فرعون إنه طغى فقل هل لك إلى أن تزكى وأهديك إلى ربك فتخشى فأراه الآية الكبرى فكذب وعصى ثم أدبر يسعى فحشر فنادى فقال أنا ربكم الأعلى فأخذه الله نكال الآخرة والأولى إن في ذلك لعبرة لمن يخشى.
جزاكم الله خيرا. حسبك.
وإياكم.
Okay. سمير. Let's continue. Verse number 36. Okay, we want to read this again, the first ra muraqqaqa and the second or the letter ra mufakhama, okay?
Okay. يَوْمَ يَتَذَكَّرُ الْإِنسَانُ مَا سَعَى وَبُرِّزَتِ الْجَحِيمُ لِمَنْ يَرَى
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 Okay.
فَأَمَّا مَنْ طَغَى وآثر الحياة الدنيا فإن الجحيم هي المأوى وأما من خاف مقام ربه ونهى النفس عن الهوى.
I want to hear this verse again, please. Verse number 40. وأما من
خاف مقام ربه وَأَمَّا مَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ وَنَهَى النَّفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَى فَإِنَّ الْجَنَّةَ هِيَ الْمَأْوَى.
It's nice to pause here because we're having Abdul Fattah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Abdul Fattah.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullah.
A junior reciter. Great. Go ahead after Abdul Fattah and recite verse number 40 again. وَأَمَّا مَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ.
Is it okay if I read a different surah?
It is okay, but it is preferable to stick to the same surah. You have the Quran open to Surat An-Naze'aat. It's page number
583.
Yeah. If you have the Quran of the Medina.
80.
I'm sorry?
What ayah?
Verse number 40. وَأَمَّا مَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ. If you're having trouble finding it, you can read from the beginning of the surah, Abdul Fattah.
Okay.
And tell me, how old are you first?
Okay. From Al-Nazi'at?
Yeah. How old are you, Abdul Fattah?
I'm 10 years old.
MashaAllah. Barakallah fiik. May Allah bless you and your family. Go ahead.
Al-Nazi'at ghorqa.
Where is the basmala?
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Al-Nazi'at ghorqa. والناشطات نشطا والسابحات سبحا فالسابقات سبقا فالمدبرات أمرا يوم ترجف الرادفة تتبعها الرادفة قلوب يومئذ واجفة أبصارها خاشعة.
عبد الفتاح.
Yes.
MashaAllah, you're reading very beautiful. But I want to give you a friendly advice.
Yes.
Open your nostrils, okay? The ghunna would only come in some cases, such as with the meem and the noon, with shadda, or in the case of ikhfa, or idgham, or iqlab, but not with all the letters. So I want you to open the passages, the nostrils, open them and recite freely, okay?
يقولون أئنا لمردودون في الحافلة خاسرة.
Better, mashallah, very good.
أَإِذَا كُنَّا عِظَامًا نَخِرَةً قَالُوا تِلْكَ إِذًا كَرَّةٌ خَاسِرَةٌ فَإِنَّمَا هِيَ زَجْرَةٌ وَاحِدَةٌ فَإِذَا هُمْ بِالسَّاحِرَةِ بِالسَّاهِرَةِ
Okay, it is السَّاهِرَة, not السَّاحِرَة. Okay, again.
فَإِذَا هُمْ بِالسَّاهِرَةِ هَلْ أَتَاكَ حَدِيثُ مُوسَى إِذْ نَادَى رَبُّهُ بِالْوَادِ الْمُقَدَّسِ طُوًى.
Hold on one second. You know when you say إِذْ نَادَى رَبُّهُ, that's different than إِذْ نَادَاهُ رَبُّهُ. Okay, it's stated in the surah, إِذْ نَادَاهُ رَبُّهُ, when his Lord called on him. Okay?
إِذْ نَادَاهُ رَبُّهُ بِالْوَادِ الْمُقَدَّسِ طُوًى اذْهَبْ إِلَى فِرْعَوْنَ إِنَّهُ طَغَى.
One second. فِرْعَوْنَ. Repeat after me. فِرْعَوْنَ.
فِرْعَوْنَ.
A little more thinner. The ra. فِرْعَوْنَ.
فِرْعَوْنَ.
Okay, Jazakallah khayran. Continue.
اذهب إلى فرعون إنه طغى فقل هل لك إلى أن تزكى وأهديك إلى ربك فتخشى فأراه الآية الكبرى فكذب وعصى ثم أدبر يسعى فحشر فنادى فقال أنا ربكم الأعلى فأخذه الله نكال الآخرة والأولى إن في ذلك لعبرة لمن يخشى.
حسبك عبد الفتاح. Thank you so much. May Allah bless you and your parents. جزاكم الله خيرا. Samir, we want to wrap it up so that Ibrahim will begin with Surah Abbas. Okay. Verse number 42. يسألونك عن الساعة.
يسألونك عن الساعة أيان مرساها فيما أنت من ذكراها إلى ربك منتهاها إنما أنت منذر من يخشاها كأنهم يوم يرونها لم يلبثوا إلا عشية أو ضحاها.
بارك الله فيك. جزاكم الله خيرا. اسمح. Thank you so much. Okay. Ibrahim, how are you today?
Fine.
Good?
Fine.
Alhamdulillah. How do you find the school?
Fine.
Good. Alhamdulillah. No, go ahead.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم عبس وتولى أن جاءه الأعمى وما يدريك لعله يزكى.
Ibrahim, beautiful recitation. But the khalqala would not tend to be a kasra. It is wama yudarika, not wama yudirika. Okay, once again. Wama yudarika la'allahu yazzakka. I'm trying to imitate you.
Wama yudarika la'allahu.
It's towards the fatha, not the kasra. Wama yudarika.
وما يدريك لعله يزكى.
وما look at me. وما يدريك.
وما يدريك لعله.
Okay, let's take sister Hafsa from United Arab Emirates, then inshallah we'll stay on it, on top of it. Hafsa, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Beginning from Surah Abbas, okay?
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم عبس وتولى أن جاءه الأعمى وما يدريك لعله وما يدريك لعله يزكى أو يذكر فتنفعه الذكرى أما من استغنى فأنت عنه تلهى وما عليك ألا يزكى
حفصة فأنت له تصدى That's verse number 6 We're still on verse number
فأنت له تصدى وما عليك ألا يزكى وأما من جاءك يسعى وهو يخشى فأنت عنه تلهى
I saw Sheikh Ismail is pointing to me. There is a difference between yakhsha and yaghsha. And just mispronouncing the kha would turn the word into yaghsha. So make sure it is wa huwa yakhsha.
Wa huwa yakhsha. Fa anta anhu talaha kalla innaha tadhkira. Fa in fama فمن شاء ذكره في صحف مكرمة مرفوعة مطهرة بأيدي سفرة كرام بررة
حسبك ما شاء الله بارك الله فيك حفصة زينب from United Arab Emirates السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته I'm coming back to you Ibrahim don't worry Go ahead, Sister Zainab.
From قتل الإنسان.
Exactly.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. قتل الإنسان ما أكفره من أي شيء خلقه من نطفة خلقه فقدره ثم السبيل يسره. ثم أماته فأقبره ثم إذا شاء أنشره كلا لما يقض ما أمره فلينظر الإنسان إلى طعامه أنا صببنا الماء صبا ثم شققنا الأرض شقا فأنبتنا فيها حبا وعنبا وقضبا
زينب I hate to stop you but with the letter dot it would really distinguish a person who is a perfect reciter from a beginner that's a dot and the dot never has qalqalah okay so we'll say وعنبا وقضبا
وعنبا وقبا
Excellent.
وزيتونا ونخلا وحدائق غلبا وفاكهة وأبا متاعا لكم ولأنعامكم
جزاكم الله خيرا زينب Thank you so much Last caller Muhammad from Egypt because I have to go back to Ibrahim
السلام
عليكم السلام Muhammad Go ahead from verse number 33, فَإِذَا جَاءَتِ الصَّاخَةِ
Okay. فَإِذَا
جَاءَتِ
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم فَإِذَا جَاءَتِ الصَّاخَةِ يَوْمَ يَفِرُّ
Six counts, Muhammad, six counts. فَإِذَا جَاءَتِ الصَّاخَّةُ
Okay. Okay. فَإِذَا جَاءَتِ الصَّاخَّةُ Okay.
Okay.
يَوْمَ يَفِرُّ الْمَرْءُ مِنْ أَخِيهِ وَأُمِّهِ وَأَبِيهِ وصاحبته وبنيه لكل امرئ منهم يومئذ شأن يغنيه وجوه يومئذ مسفرة ضاحكة مستبشرة ووجوه يومئذ عليها غبرة ترهقها قترة أولئك هم الكفرة الفجرة بسم الله.
جزاك الله خيرا محمد حسبك بارك الله فيك. Now Ibrahim, I want to have the best ending. I want to listen to your beautiful recitation from the beginning of the surah again.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. عبس وتولى أن جاءه الأعمى وما يدريك لعله يزكى أو يذكر فتنفعه الذكرى أما من استغنى فأنت له تصدى وما عليك ألا يزكى وأما من جاءك يسعى وهو يخشى فأنت عنه تلهى كلا إنها تذكرة فمن شاء ذكره في صحف مكرمة مرفوعة مطهرة.
Can we read again from verse number 11 and make sure that ذال doesn't have a qalqala? And make sure you give the ghunna of the idgham with ghunna fi suhufim mukarrama. Okay?
Okay.
Kalla innaha.
Kalla innaha tadhkira. Faman shaa dhakara. Fi suhufim mukarrama. مرفوعة مطهرة بأيدي سفرة كرام بررة.
Okay, the ba in general, the ba is one of the tafqim or tarqiq letters. Tarqiq, right?
Yeah.
And this will say Bismillah, bi ba bu, right?
Yeah.
But because it is followed by ra, and the ra has fatha, so there is tendency to make the ba, ba, barara. But one has to be very careful and give every letter its rights and due characteristics. So its due characteristic is the tarqiq. I would say, kiramin barara. So ba muraqqaqa, then ra mufakhama. And you've got two ra's. Okay.
Kiramin barara.
Okay, I want you to listen to it from Sheikh Ismail.
Kiramin barara.
Look at the change from ba ra. Ba ra. Kiramin ba ra ra. Okay?
Kiramin barara.
Jazakumullah khayr. Thank you so much. May Allah bless you and the family. Brothers and sisters, enjoyed being with you today. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep this program and all the programs on Huda TV running for good as long as we live until the day of judgment, inshallah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and make it even better. Thank you so much for joining us live today. And until next time, I leave you in peace. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Jazakumullah khayr.
Brothers and sisters, to increase your iman, read the miracle, recite the Quran. Recite it every day and do read it loud. The verses of Quran are all Muslims' pride. This miracle was revealed over a long time span, sent from Allah to an angel then to a man. That man was Muhammad, the best of creation. We were chosen to be part of his nation. He gave us a message, and that was Islam. So read this miracle, recite the Quran.